Good find Tinder. Dry grass. Very good Tinder. Looks like a nice dry place to make some bow drill practicing.
First of all, to the bow drill kit. Keep the stuff dry. I prefer softwood on softwood. Same spindle, same wood. This is basswood, for example. Spruce is very good. Willow works well. And quite some other wood and wood combinations. A good size for a spindle is this. Your measurement, your body is your measurement for your stuff. The length of an arrow. Your body is the measurement. A bearing block. This is a rock with a hole from a drill. You also can use, if you have patience, time, a flint stone. You can also make a hole in such a river rock. If you use fresh wood, it's bendable. You can keep this on it. It's good to for the binding, for the lashings. All the rope and string and stuff I have with me has always the size to make a fire bow. Simple overhand knot. Because the bow is flexible, you can make it exact the same size, the same length. Because if you give the spindle in it, you have the tension, the strength from the bended bow. You should always have the loop outside, not inside. Inside can happen, you pull the spindle out of the fireboard. Better keep it on the outside. This is for right-handed people, left-handed. If you have dry wood or the bow get old and hard, you choose the length of your rope 1.5 diameter from your spindle, and then you always have a good grip with the spindle. You can go through resin with the rope and you have also extra grip. You can use your tinder bundle to catch the ember and the dust. Search for a clean place, because otherwise you hang and wriggle around with your fire bow. Make a small hole. in your fireboard so that the spindle has a start. This spindle still looks good. If it gets too hard like glass, you should file it away on a rock, for example. You can carve it, but if you carve it, the spindle gets short very soon. This form you get the loop outside. You have to be very stable here. If you wriggle around too much, you get not enough heat. Make good smoke, good black powder, and you have a good chance for an ember. I think I got the ember, and this is the first time in my bushcraft life that I get the ember without making a notch. But even this is possible, maybe if you have not a good knife and you make the hole just with a stone, with a rock. This is crazy. This is scale. So, but this is not normal. For normal, collect the first dust you have made, and from the shoe to the snow it's wet, so you have not endless time to work with your dry material. For normal, you cut a notch in your heart, in your board. I start with a V notch, and then I go 1/3 with a U notch close to the center of the hole. This is crazy. Then I use my dust. It hurts to kill the ember. But for normal, you have no ember at this moment. So you go on the place where you collect your material. Again, you go in your, give in the spindle. A little airflow is good, not too much wind, but you see a little airflow is good to get the ember. I have to turn it around, because otherwise if I stay here with my leg, I break the board. For the ember, for normal ember, you need speed, you need heat, you need dust, and at least you need pressure. But not from the beginning. speed. The smoke is heat. The heat makes dust and powder and at least a little pressure. Now ignites the dust. Basswood on basswood. Amazing combination. Now you have time, let the ember grow. It's a little brown, I gave a little too much pressure in it, but for me not much problem. Just if you make this for the first time, be careful. So I'm still here. Yeah. Oh yeah, okay. Sorry, I see the lens has a problem with the cold. So now the wind help you close it good here, otherwise you can lose your ember or you burn yourself because the ember fell in here. To drain this I can recommend take a little piece of ember out from your normal campfire, give it in a tinder bundle and try to ignite the piece of ember into flames. I often see people, they make their first ember and they are proud, wow, first ember from the bow drill, and then they lose the ember in the process of blow it into flame. If you blow it into flame, make an exact strong airflow direct in the ember. You have just this chance. It works or it works not. And this works. Make it out in the snow. Also from time to time you still there. Also from time to time you do not need your whole tinder bundle because you have a fire tipi prepared before you make the flame, and then you can pull out the tinder and use it for another time. To not lose the spindle, a few tips. You can give it in once, but you also can give it in twice. But here you see I have you see me with this stuff. I control the bow here and make here the work with the spindle, and then I just make this. The bow is nearly the useless thing in the bow drill. It's the last thing you need. Don't take care about the bow as long as your spindle is not correct. Otherwise, this happens. So, to have more tension, give it in twice in your bow. Practice this stuff. Ferro rod has an end, or you can lose a ferro rod, lighter matches and stuff, but you never lose the knowledge and technique if you are good in the bow drill. We most of the time use paracord, and paracord is super, but we do not always have paracord. We could cut away clothing, a ring from our t-shirt for example, and use it. We can use, if we find trash, we can use a trash bag. Plastic is good for a bow drill. You can use the shoe lenses, but shoe lenses sadly stretch and then they get hot and damaged. Quite some people were successful with natural cordage. It's better to work with a clove hitch. Make one loop in the same direction, and give the second loop behind the first loop. Make the clove hitch in the middle of your spindle, pull it tight, and then make some wrappings around your spindle. Board, bearing block, now we can make this, and for a natural cordage, for shoelaces and so on, this is not so much tension on a rope, and maybe a little more grip on your spindle. Another way is to drill a hole in your spindle. I think the way with the clove hitch is called the Australian. Spindle in the snow is very good. It's called the Australian bow drill, and the hole in the spindle I think is the Egypt way to make a bow drill. So with the ale on my Swiss Army knife, the wooden scales on it, I drill a hole through the spindle. This has the benefit your rope does not move upside down, upside, and you lose it here. So now I see where I came out, and I go inside from this place. Use your cordage and go through the spindle in the middle of the of your bow length, and you make the same like with the clove hitch before. You make some wrapping around your spindle, and this is the space you have to turn the spindle around. Also, the next benefit, the spindle always moves. If the spindle is still and you go with the cordage, you damage the cordage. So always look out that the spindle works well. Sometimes I go inside the board with such a point with four edges, such a tip. The board should not move, otherwise you get not enough heat. Now you see the heat, the smoke. And the tip get round again. If you like to type in bow drill on the channel video search on my channel, you will find quite a lot of bow drills, also with freshly collected material. For me, the friction fire method is a must-have. Also the hand drill, I feel much more safe with it. Everything else you can lose. Knowledge you will not lose. Hope you could enjoy it a little, and maybe you find something from it interesting. Many thanks for watching. We have March, the training season starts again together with Vival Ranger, with Joe Vogel. I'm looking forward to a very great training season and to all the nice people who will join me in these courses. Danke, wenn's euch vorbeikommt. Goodbye to you all. Sepp Waldhandwerk, für euch. Geht's aus. Ciao. Servus.